Hey guys, welcome back to Log Rocket. I'm going to show you some of the plugins that fasten the way you add images on your project. Number one is going to be Unsplash. So to find Unsplash, go to this place and head to plugin, then search for Unsplash. Once you find it, that is Unsplash, you're just going to click it. As you may want to change some of these images on this design, what I'm going to do now is to search for party images. So say party, and it's going to give me some options of party images that I could choose from to add on this image. To replace this image, I can use this. Once I want to replace this image with this, all I would do is just select this and click on this. So it's going to replace it. Sometimes it takes time depending on the strength of your network. So once that is done, you see this image has been replaced, but we replaced it on a frame. So I'm just going to double click to select the image that I want to replace. So I'm just going to click on that image again to replace it. So now the image has been replaced. So if we want to replace this image here, I'm just going to go back and search for portraits. Is looking for the right portrait image that I could use. I'll just browse tons of portrait images that you could use, and I could just select this one. So once I pick this one, it's just going to replace what we have here. We can also use the same method to change all of this image. So that is how you can actually use Unsplash to select some of the images that you need to use on your project. So the next one, which is going to be number two, is actually not a plugin but a platform that I use a lot, and that is Pinterest. So this is Pinterest where I actually get some of my images that I use while designing. So this platform has really helped me a lot because it helps me narrow down the type of image that I want. I want something like wedding gown, I'll just say wedding gown. Now once this is out, you will see all so many options that has to do with wedding gown. So you can actually go through the whole image suggestions that has been shown to you to pick the one you want. So please don't pick image like this. So I'm going to show you how you're going to copy this image and paste it on your Figma file. So the next thing I'm going to do is search for party, and yeah, it's going to give us our option. So once the option is out, I'm just going to open the image. So we're just going to scan through it and see the one that aligns best for what we are trying to do. So once I'm okay with this, I'll just open it up. Please don't copy the image on the thumbnail. Don't copy the image thumbnail. So while this is loading, now that the image has been fully loaded, I'm just going to right click and copy this image. So go back to where you're designing and select the image you want to replace and just press Ctrl V to replace that image. And it's just as simple as that. So if we want to replace this one too, we're going to go back again, and yep, we're going to go back again to look for another image that will replace the second one. Let's try out this one. One thing you have to learn about Pinterest is if you open Pinterest, please allow the image to settle before you copy. Don't just open it and copy it immediately, because that way the image hasn't really been fully loaded. So you need to copy it when the image is fully loaded. So now I'm just going to go back to the design, select this image and paste. Ctrl V and paste it. That's just it. Or you could just right click and see paste here, and you paste your image. So the number three that I have on my list is going to be Freepik. I use it a lot. So if you want to go to get to this platform, you just type freepik.com. So here it's the same thing. You can search for any image you want. So I'm just going to search for party because we are designing something that relates to parties. So you can also browse through tons of images that they have. You can just, similar to what we did on the Pinterest platform, you could just open this up, and once it's open, you can copy it. Don't copy the thumbnail, rather open up the image before you copy and allow the image to settle before you can actually copy image. Then go back to your design, select this. As you may want to replace this one, just press Ctrl V, and voila, we're done with that. These are the three platforms that I always use while browsing all the images that I use on my project. Some of the high resolution images that I get is from freepik.com and Pinterest. I also use images from Unsplash, and you can actually try this out and let me know what you think. Please don't forget to subscribe to Log Rocket for some content like this. I'm going to see you guys on the next video. Bye for now.